Hey everyone, Jeremy Wiseman here with Wiseman Family Practice. I'm here in Cedar Park, Texas, and what we're going to do today is look at the best approach for purifying our tap water. Now, I think most people understand there's a connection between pure water and true health. In fact, it's my belief that clean water and clean food are really the cornerstones for disease prevention. Now, cities and towns create complex infrastructures for purifying water by filtering acute toxins and filtering chronic toxins or keeping chronic toxins at a safe level. Unfortunately, the end result is tap water that is not entirely pure. And in fact, most tap water contains a number of toxins that I believe when consumed over time can increase a number of health conditions. So what exactly is in our tap water? Pathogens. Bacteria, viruses, and parasites are pathogens commonly found in drinking water. Toxic minerals and metals. Aluminum, arsenic, asbestos, barium, chlorine, and other known toxic inorganic substances are also found in our drinking water. Organic chemicals. Herbicides, paints, plastics, and pharmaceutical drugs are among the many kinds of organic chemicals found in our drinking water. Additives. Water treatment plants add a variety of chemical agents to disinfect water. Chlorine is the most commonly used, but is not properly removed. Fluoride is another common additive. Radioactive substances. Radioactive minerals and radioactive gases can be present in tap water. So what is the best approach for filtering our tap water that is effective, convenient, and not too costly? Because a lot of the filters that are used out there, from the pitcher type filter to the refrigerator filters, really don't provide the maximum amount of protection. So I believe the best filter that provides the greatest amount of toxin filtration comes in a multi-stage reverse osmosis system. And that's exactly what we're gonna look at today. So we're gonna look at one of these systems, we're gonna talk to a local water expert on how these systems are installed and how they're maintained. And at the end, we're gonna look at a simple strategy for filtering our shower or bathing water. So let's get started. Okay, Terry, so this is a multi-stage reverse osmosis system, obviously on a table. This is usually found under a sink. Can you explain this system?
You betcha. The water is going to come through a 5-micron sediment filter first. It's going to get bigger particulate matter, actually things you can't even see, will get removed here. Then it's going to come to a 1-micron carbon block filter. That is some really good filtration. I mean, that by itself will get cryptosporidium, Giardia cyst. So these two are really making a good combination. It'll then go to an extended contact time filter. This is carbon, so you're going to get a wide range of VOCs removed that you might not have gotten here. And then from there, you're making really good three different steps of processes leading to the reverse osmosis membrane. And then the water passes on through to the storage tank. Now, when you do push on that faucet to get water out of here, it actually goes through the last stage, and this is a 5-stage process, so this is the 5th stage, and really it acts like a polish. It's a 10-micron granular activated carbon filter. And that's gonna really give it a good taste. That's what it's there for.
And then from there, obviously it goes to the faucet, so. Okay, well let's look at it under the sink.
Sure.
Okay, Terry, so this is the RO system installed, and of course the tank is behind this cabinet here. Can you explain?
Yeah, this just gives us the visual when we were at the table going through the processes. This is what it looks like underneath the sink. It'll go through the same process, but it all starts with the cold water feed. There's an angle stop underneath every sink for your hot and cold. So we come off of that cold, and that's what feeds the RO system, and then it follows that path like what we were talking about at the table.
Okay. Well, let's go look at the faucet. Okay, Terry, so this is the regular faucet, regular tap water, and I use this for washing my hands and, of course, washing dishes. And this is the RO faucet, and you personally install these, is that correct?
Correct.
Okay. So let's look at the difference in water purity between the regular faucet and the RO faucet.
All right, Jeremy, this is a TDS monitor. It's going to measure the total dissolved solids. This gives us an idea not individually what there is in the water, but how much there is. So. Is 267 parts per million of total dissolved solids.
So it doesn't tell you which ones, it just tells
you. No, it gives us the overall. You'd have to be a laboratory to be able to break it down individually. This just lets me know how much.
Gotcha, okay. And let's look at the RO source.
38 parts per million. So we dropped from 267 to 38. What that's letting me know, well, obviously by the number, you're getting a much more pure water than what you started with right here. That's why it's gonna be so much better for your cooking and drinking. Your source, that membrane's going on a couple years old, your own hard water. So we're beginning to get some scaling. Because typically I'll be getting around a 10, maybe less than 20.
Yeah, when we initially tested, it was around 15,
I
think.
That is correct.
Right. And that includes fluoride, includes basically...
Now, fluoride, you don't get the 90 to 95. You're going to be, I think it's like in the high 70s, low 80s. You don't get it quite the rejection on it.
Okay, Terry, so that addresses purifying our drinking water. What are your thoughts about purifying our shower or bathing water?
I think it's extremely important. Skin, semi-permeable sheath, we actually absorb, or at least I've read, more through the pores of our skin than when we drink water.
Right.
So I think doing something either at the point of entry, which could be difficult prior to it coming into the house, as opposed to a point of use, which could be just right at your shower head, that could be removing and giving you a much better quality of water.
Right, and again, most of us shower so much that we are absorbing a lot of these toxins through our skin, and of course the hot water, we inhale them a lot too, so it can be quite dangerous. Yeah, I use a shower filter made from Mercola. Now, this is a replacement cartridge, and again, it comes with the shower unit. And basically, what you do is you screw it on. I replace it every 3 months. So, can you explain what a typical shower head filter, the mechanism that this brings to the table?
Sure, Jeremy. They're going to have carbon inside there, but that size, you just can't get enough carbon. You'd be changing those filters so quickly. What they actually will use in conjunction with it is KDF, or copper and zinc alloy. It's a mixture. It will actually start changing a lot of the chlorine to a chloride and trap it on the surface, and it'll make that carbon last as much as 15 times longer.
Okay. Yeah, so I think it's such an easy way to get rid of, you know, a good amount of the toxins, because again, we're showering so much. And again, most people take really long showers and hot showers, so I do think this is an excellent strategy. Thanks, Terry.
Thank you.
Thanks, everyone. So remember the two strategies for purifying tap water. For drinking water, use a multi-stage reverse osmosis system. And for bathing water, use a simple shower head filter. So I want to thank Terry from A+ Water Conditioning. And now I'm going to provide some websites and some information so you can purchase some of these products, and of course, Terry's number. If you have any more questions, you can reach me at wisemanfamilypractice.com. Thanks again.